First thing was, you know, when you ask people what they think of when they think of Bioshock, they probably think about the location. And for us, what's so important about location is that it's something to explore, it's something mysterious, and it's something new. And we wanted to bring people to an entirely new place, something they hadn't seen before from us or anybody else. And that's where Columbia came from. You feel like when you go into it, you don't know the answers to any of the questions. And I think that was what was so great about the original game, that we wanted to get back, which is that sort of WTF feeling. You know, what is this place? Where am I? And for us, it's also doing things very differently in terms of, like, in this game, you know who you are. You know you're a particular character. You're not a cipher like you were in the first game. You're not, we wanted to get away from characters you interact with behind, glass windows. Because honestly, I think that's something I may have invented. I'm not so proud of it necessarily, but always interacting with people over the radio or glass windows, you know, that you're with Elizabeth, that you're interacting with her, that she's in the world. And you saw, we also wanted the kind of combats that you wouldn't see, you know, in a game, in like the original Bioshock, where you're basically going down corridors, fighting two or three guys at a time. Here you see you're fighting like 15 guys at a time. You're fighting them over vast spaces or intimate spaces. You're going at 60 miles per hour on these skylines. There's just totally different experiences that you would never have in a previous game. We started basically from scratch. We had a feeling of what we wanted to make. And if you look at our previous games, maybe for Bioshock, you'll see some similarities. You'll see some connective tissue there. I think you'll see as much differences between this and the previous Bioshock as you'll see between that game and some of our previous games. But to us, you know, if you look at America around 1900, it was this amazing time of optimism. And you see this flying city. People thought there were going to be flying cities. You know, 20 years before this, there was cows and fields. Now there was radios and television and movies and airplanes and automobiles. And that's, I think, very consistent with the Bioshock franchise, that it takes the vibe of a time, the spirit of a time, and then goes to a different place with it. The most important thing for us is, you know, I think we've all played games where you're with various characters. And for us, the challenge is that we want that character to be meaningful from a gameplay standpoint, that we had a character that was driving you in a narrative sense, that was meaningful to you in a narrative sense, that wasn't talking to you in your ear over the radio or wasn't speaking to you through a glass window. She's been locked in basically a tower, think of Rapunzel almost, for 15 years since she was a little girl, and she doesn't know why. And that's one thing she's trying to figure out, is why was I locked there? Why, you know, who put me there? Why was I there? And that's something you're gonna have to figure out during the course of the game. There's gonna be, let me just say, there's gonna be a lot more weapons and powers, and there's gonna be a lot more degree of granularity to the kind of ways you can grow yourself. And I'm not gonna get into a huge amount of detail there, but one thing we heard is that people felt there wasn't enough sort of expressiveness in the character growth. And that's something we're really looking into and really working on. There's also just gonna be, in terms of raw numbers of stuff, it's gonna be a lot bigger. Like, we're looking at some time in 2012 where I guess we're early in development. We have been working on it for a couple years already, but we still have a long way to go. And you know, the way we work, we are constantly evolving. You know, we learn stuff from everything we do. We learn stuff from making this demo for you guys. It's relatively early for us, but that's what's really nice, is having all this time already to be working on it. Making a new engine, you know, starting a new piece of code base is challenging. And that took a long time even just to get that rolling.